Alright, now for the next build. The Eclipse Protocol build. We're gonna go to Haven later, and I'm gonna try and remember why I chose this specialization, because honestly I can't remember. I think it had to do with trying to do the manhunt, the Manning Zoo time trial for the whatever league it was, Thermite League or whatever. Why you had to do a Manning Zoo in under 18, sub 18. And at first I started doing it with a DPS build, and I had to do it over and over again, playing it solo before I was able to sub 18. And when I did, I remember on the forum there was this guy that posted a link to his video where he was about to get a really good time with an Eclipse Protocol build. And that's when I started playing with it. And I've made some change. I watched Rambob video on it to get some tips about how to maximize the status effect. So let me show you all how this works. I have the pyromaniac because I'm gonna be, lighting enemies on fire. So this is perfectly ignited. I have extra damage to burning enemies. So whenever I'm gonna ignite an enemy like an elite or purple bar or whatever, if I want him to die faster, or even to die on heroic, he's not gonna die. I'm gonna be. This is a good talent, and this is a good, damage to target out of cover, health damage. This is a good rolls. This one I used it for the Manning Zoo challenge because you get tanks and you get 100 bullet in the mag. You also get in sync, and I used to play with a drone, but I still kept it because it can be useful on tanks because of all the how many bullet you have, So it's a nice weapon. I don't have the right skill because I was trying something in the summit. So let me change that fire starter. And then for this mission, for the Luna League, it was Pathway Park. I was using a hive for the final part to get Kajika to get down from his place. I would just throw the hive upstairs, and it was really great. But anything that has status effect is gonna be good. So you can go with the hive, you can go with even Jammer Pulse if you're facing drones and stuff. Oh, you can also couple it with the burn sticky bomb. I just don't know how to use it. I've never used it. I've never used it yet, but this is a really good combo. I've seen Rambob and other players using this combo. And you can also use the firewall spec. Firewall spec and have can have a shield obviously, but you can use the flamethrower. Just have to ignite a few enemies and it's gonna work really great. Anyways, this will give me the opportunity to try this. Okay, I have to detonate it. And it's on a cooldown, okay. So I'm gonna launch the mission on heroic. I'm gonna go over the build, maybe. I forgot that. So I'm using the Vile Mask, okay? Because I have a status effect. The hazard protection is just what comes with the mask. And then I have some skill haste here. Toxic delivery. Status effect also apply a damage over time debuff for 10 seconds. Total damage dealt is equal to 15% of your concussion grenade damage and increased by your status effect attributes. So basically, this is a mask that is good for status effect, and it's a mask that is good with the Eclipse Protocol. Almost like it was made for it. Then I have the Eclipse Protocol backpack with status effect and skill haste. You want that talent. amplifies all damage you did to stealth affected targets by 13%. Stealth effect again, skill haste, and you get this talent increases indirect transmission range from 10 to 15 meters and refresh percentage from 50 to 75%. And basically, when you have the, let's go over the gear set. So two pieces give you plus 15% status effect. Three pieces is 15% skill haste and 30% hazard protection. So with the mask, that's a total of I can't remember. It's 9.5 and this is okay, so that's almost 40% hazard protection. That's huge. And four pieces, your status effect now spread on kill to all enemies within 10 meters and refresh. So it's 15 meters and refresh percentage of 75%. So it's really beast. And then I use this pair of gloves. I recalibrated, it has a blue, it had a blue attribute here. I recalibrated it to get the skill tier 1 because you want to be skill tier 6. So if you have another pair of gloves that is going to be like if you're going to be using maybe a hive and you want to use the BTSU gloves, the exotic gloves, you can do that too. I wanted to go mass ma max status effect and skill haste. So this was a really good pair of gloves because I have an extra 10% status effect and I have 10% skill haste. And then some more status effect, always. And status effect. So if you go to the stats, let me see. So I have 71% skill haste. I'm gonna change the mods here. The cooldown is 16.4. The cloud radius is 4.8. Cloud duration is 6. Oh, okay, I thought it was much than that. Repair. Wait. Chem launcher. Hang on a second. Oh yeah, okay. That's better. That's better. That was something wrong. So I'm gonna put an extra ammo here, and I'm gonna go with burn strength. There you go. Okay, now that's better. The cloud radius is almost 4. Cloud duration is 24. Okay, that's more like it. The damage, the burn damage. So you need to be careful because this build is actually pretty strong. If you're playing on normal difficulty and you shoot a. Let's see if I can find one. Oh, and this pistol gives me. Yeah, it gives me a plus one skill tier. I don't know if it overloads, overcharges, overload. What am I saying? Yeah, if I'm aiming at the. Yeah, if I'm aiming at normal enemies, red bars, NPC, the deflagration, the explosion from the chem launcher is gonna kill them. So it's gonna kill them before they catch on fire. So there's no burning effect, there's no spread of the burning effect. So the build is actually too strong for normal. So you want to be playing on a hard difficulty, or you want to nerf your build maybe a little, or you want to be playing on hard and above. And usually I think this build is ideal for hard and challenging, but it can also work on it can also work on heroic. What is this? Why are they targeting me? They're so far away. Come on. So yeah, let's see how we do. I'm gonna launch the mission. Oh, there's a way to, but I don't know if I'm gonna be able to do it. I haven't done that in a long time. You can actually get one of the enemies. I doubt this is gonna work, but we'll see. Yeah, it didn't work. You have to aim at a very... See, then you just have to watch them burn, basically. So obviously they were all red NPCs, so it was really, really effective. It was very strong against them. And if you're playing on heroic, it's not going to be the same on purple bars and elite enemies. You might have to use your weapon, but you can see it's still very, very effective, and you don't have to do anything. So I could have actually run through the room and just ignore the enemies. Let me try that again. Wait, I want to do something. I used to have this. On this side, okay. What about this? Burn duration, okay. Skill haste. Okay. Oh, that's better. I still missed, but what are the enemies? Oh, okay. See, I can just run. Look at this, I'm not doing anything. The guy in the back, yeah, he's not affected because he was too far away. Unknown network detected. Isaac's picking up a signal in the underground. So as you can see, it's a strong build. But the problem is whenever you're facing a tank, especially here where the tanks don't get affected by the burn duration, by the burning effect, then, well, it's not gonna help you much, right? Burn effect. Bleed effect. Okay, I'm gonna use this for the tank maybe. Oh no, actually, I know what I'm gonna be using. Drone. There you go. Now this isn't the build I would use for if I'm doing a speedrun. I'm gonna be using it for the just for this part. Then I'm gonna switch to DPS here for this part, and when I'm done with this part, I'm gonna switch again to the Eclipse Protocol build. If you're playing on hard or challenging, you can keep the build for the entirety of the run. But if you're doing a speed run, you know you're gonna waste time with the tanks. But since I want to show you how effective it is, I'm not gonna go for DPS here. Okay, that's an elite. Okay, but it's a rusher, so it doesn't have a lot of armor, actually. And my drone is actually finishing them off, so... I'm gonna try to get closer. That didn't work. Oh fuck, sorry. I thought I walked into the fire. Okay, so... Oh, obviously, I forgot to say. Let me get rid of the drone for a second. You can ignite your fire starter by double tapping whatever key you have. I have the E key. So when I shoot my fire stat, I don't have to actually shoot the gas cloud. Like, I'm gonna double tap now, and it ignites automatically. And also, with the chem launcher, you don't really have to aim amazingly. If an enemy is behind that cover, if I shoot here, as long as you see that your AOE, your zone of impact, it gets red, it means that the enemy is within range. Again, it's not gonna work on this guy. This is why you want a DPS build for this part. This is when I'm gonna be using my my LMG. So see, you can still deal with the tanks, but if I have had my DPS build here, it would have been faster. Okay, let's try this again. So usually this is a build depending on the mission that I'm gonna use, with a drone or sometimes a hive, usually the striker drone. Then you just have to aim, double tap, and then you can basically run away. It's very, 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 very strong. Just need to be sure that you're gonna know where the enemy is gonna be. See, my gas cloud was red, and that's all I need to know. There's an enemy over there. Probably gonna die, by the way. That's it.
Make no mistake, we may have caught him off guard, but we sure as hell have his attention now.
So, he's in the catbird. If you're lucky for this part, you can shoot your first gas cloud here. So ignite all these enemies, you're gonna kill them, and when you get there, you can actually go here. Sometimes an enemy will stop over there or over there, and if you manage to get him, at this point, you may have to shoot him a little if he's an elite or something, but then everybody is gonna burn. But there, the enemy that spawned, he went all the way back there. So one of the enemy went all the way back here, and he wasn't in range. But this build is really good because if you know the spawns, if you know where the enemy are gonna get, after a few tries, you're gonna be able to get to deal with rooms in a matter of seconds with one or two shots of the chem launcher. If you do it at the right time, at the right place, you're gonna be able to shoot, ignite, not even look behind you, look over your shoulder. You're just gonna run to the next part. Like even here, and again, if you know how to use the other skill that I don't really know, you can also do this. Oh, you're in my way. Oh, I mean, yeah, whenever it's red NPC, you don't even have to shoot them. So that's it. I think that's enough. Again, this other skill, I just never used it, so. But you can use it with a chem launcher for an extra burning burning skill. So if you ever run out of come on, oh okay, it burns on impact and then you can detonate it. That's very nice. Okay, that's it for this build. Next time I'm gonna show Yeah, I'm gonna shut this build. So, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers. Yeah, I forgot something. I forgot to... Maybe I'm gonna take a quick look at... What is this? What is this? Why is it zoomed in like this? I can't... Where am I? I don't even know where I am. Out of bounds. What is this? Man, I can't. Oh, come.
Agent killed.
Okay, maybe because I was there, but that's really weird because you can't even go back to Haven or something. I'm gonna go over the specialization. I think I chose it for the at the time for the for my secondary weapon, my LMG, because it used to be my primary weapon for Manning Zoo. It's the only weapon I used. But we're gonna check that out. See if there's any benefit to it. You could also, just thought about that, you could also use the technician spec to get plus one skill tier so that you don't have to recalibrate this, you know? And you could, if you have the technician spec, you will have plus one skill tier, so you will be skill tier 6. And you can either get some more status effect, max status effect, or you can go with some more skill haste. I just thought about that. It's too late to do that now, but anyway, let me see. Okay, so I think I also did it for, I also chose this specialization for this. For the LMG. Maybe for these two. I'm not doing this for the Banshee. Actually, you can actually use the Banshee with this because it works with status effect. I just thought about that. So you can use the Chem Launcher and Banshee. That's actually a good idea. Okay. Ammunition. Oh, the rate of fire is the other reason why I chose this. To have on kill. Oh, okay, so it's not great. Okay, well, again, might be a good idea to get the technician spec so that you can get even more status effect or even more skill haste. Okay, that's it for now. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.